Welcome to SubAssembler. This is my first video, and we're here to unbox the new XM Studios quarter scale Spider-Man statue. And I've been collecting statues actually for many years. However, I haven't had the space to display my statues properly. However, that's changed now, and therefore I'm planning to post more unboxing videos from all the statues I'm planning to publish and display properly. Some of the statues will be newer ones, some of them will be older ones. For example, one of the newer ones, I'm expecting the new XM Studios Predator statue next month. I think that's a statue a lot of collectors have been expecting with great happiness and with a lot of ambition. And if this is actually my first unboxing video, as I said, and if I make any mistakes, please let me know, and I'll try to improve that in my next video. And so you'll just have to expect and accept some mistakes. So let's just get started with Spider-Man. Inside the video, you will find the assembly manual, this little box here, or not box, this little kind of booklet, and you'll also get the regular portrait picture from XM Studios, and I'm really happy they always give you this with it, and this actually looks phenomenal. It looks great. I'll give you some better close-ups of this properly later. Yeah, well, it actually shows it's a picture of it, and you have Green Goblin in the background. You have some of the tentacles of Doc Ock. I'll just put these aside for now.
Together and make it work.
Welcome back. Let's continue with it. It's putting the piece together. I've taken out all the pieces and as normal, let's start with the base. Here we have these small pieces you have to take out. We don't need them. We have the assembly booklet. Do we need it? I think I do. Let's get started with part one. The thing says let's get started with this piece, and let's put this piece together here. It's actually a really nice base. When I saw this piece first, I wasn't like too thrilled about it, but when I see it in person now, it looks actually more impressive than on the photo. So I'm just saying that if you have the chance, here at the bottom you have some pieces, Sandman, and I don't know if this is and here of the you have here you have like tentacle from Doc Ock, and here you have the next piece. I think is this. I think this goes here. I think you have to put these things here together. Yeah, that's right. You have to, and the longer tentacle from Doc Ock. I think you have the other part here on top. This piece actually is actually bigger than it looks on the photos. And some other parts here, I guess, will be this here. Goes here and this piece here goes right around the top part. goes right here. I guess this goes right here. I think get started here with the legs of Spider-Man that fit in right here on the side. Goes in pretty smoothly. I'm happy about that. Another part, the other Green Goblin pumpkin bomb. Well, the next part would be, I guess, the top, the torso. Which one should we start with? Let's start with my, I think, least favorite. It's the one with the smaller eyes, as you can see. So, least favorite, so we keep the best for last, so... we start with the other arm, the one arm, then we have the fist goes down here. The spider webs go one piece at the top, the other one, and you get two pieces that go here at the bottom on the other side of the arm. So, here we have Spider-Man, and I don't know if you can, let's see if you can see him properly. Let's swap the torso and let's put on the battle damage, torso here. Actually, it looks pretty cool. Actually, I wasn't too thrilled. I could imagine using this torso for a display. As you can see, it's actually, the detail is really cool. And I like this one with the big eyes. I'm probably gonna use this one most of the time. I could imagine using this sometimes, but I'm not sure yet. I still haven't decided, but probably I'll be using this one. Let's swap out the you have regular Spider-Man torso. It's amazing piece actually, and I love it. Probably going to be using this one. I'm pretty sure the one with the small eyes, I'm probably not going to be using that. But I could imagine using this occasionally with the battle damage portrait. Display Spider-Man properly here. Wow, actually this is a really nice piece. I'm positively surprised, because when I saw this piece, when I saw the first pictures or photos of this piece, I was not like too thrilled. The only reason I was planning to get it was because I already started with the XM Studios Sinister Six series, and I wanted to kind of complete that series. But when I see it in person, This is actually a really impressive piece. Photos actually don't do this piece justice at all. This is a piece you have to see in person, because that's when you actually get the full beauty of the statue, and you get the whole feeling how dynamic this piece is and how actually big it is. Actually, on the photos it looks pretty small, but when you see this in reality, it's actually a really big piece. And here at the bottom you have it implies like you have Doc Ock, you have the Green Goblin pumpkin bombs, and Sandman, and I don't know if this is maybe a electric coil. Maybe that's maybe it implies a little bit electro. That's just an idea. I'm not sure about that. Could be, maybe not. Prove me wrong if I'm. Let me know if I'm wrong, and give me comments. And if you're planning to get this piece, please don't hesitate. Get this piece immediately. You definitely will not be disappointed, I can tell you that. If you subscribe to my channel, Subassembler, and I know this video wasn't that good. This is, as I said, this is my first video, and give me some comments and some tips how I can improve it, and I'll do that on my next video, and I'm sure the next video will be better. Thanks, and I wish you subscribe, as I said, and give me like, give me a dislike, be my guest. It's okay. So I wish you a nice day.